Hello and welcome to the channel. My name is Corey, the Skinny Fat Duck, and today we are hopping back into our playthrough of Chicken Police Painted Red. I just did something weird with my headphones, so that's a pretty good start to the episode. Let's go back to the Hotel Atlas.
We had no choice but to continue the investigation where it started. In that shady little apartment I called home. The only lead was the list Fillmore gave us, with all those imposing names on it.
But wow, that's hot.
What could it mean? And why did Natasha keep it secret from us? But most importantly, what did all this have to do with Deborah's death? The trail started to get cold, and so did the air outside. There was something unsettling in the black clouds, hiding all the stars. I prayed that they didn't bring an early snowfall. The night was already painful enough.
So, what are we doing here?
Trying to calm down. I'll have a shot.
Sure you will.
And we're trying to put the pieces together, of course. Figure out what's next.
And what is next, Boss Bird?
Let's take a look at what we've learned so far.
No.
So, how did this whole case start?
Well, let's investigate. Started with strange threats. None of these people are suspects. Or, I mean, I don't guess they are. At least at this point. Let's go with who the threats are against and see what happens. That's it. All right. We're making our conspiracy theory board. All right. She's a source of... I'm sorry, I need to read this out loud. I apologize. Natasha and the threats, but what's the connection? They make her suspicious. She's the source of them. They were clearly addressed to her. They clearly weren't for her. They all have to do with her or occur around her, so
yeah,
let's go with that.
The threats are meant for Natasha, no doubt about that.
Yeah. I'm sorry, I'm having a catastrophic failure of my coaster. So, not only am I bad at video games, but I'm pretty bad at putting drinks down on tables. The list goes on and on. Do we do an item? Card, maybe? Okay. Important, but not now. Let's try the check. Okay, well, that's clearly it. She gave us the list.
But there was something,
I guess,
Natasha didn't speak about.
She kept it secret. She showed it to us. She lied about it. She just forgot to mention. She kept it secret. I thought she showed it to us. Nope, that's not right.
She kept it secret. And she's in real danger. But she kept this list hidden from us. It seems too important to keep it a secret.
All right, well, it's hard to fail this, so that's good. Evan Lewis. All right, so she's dead. All right, that's no. No. All right, that's it.
But what can we do with this list?
He has something to do with it. It makes him suspicious. He used it as a diversion. He may know something about it. I'm not going to lie. It's been a couple of weeks since I've played this part of the game, so I don't remember how this worked. He may know something about it. Yeah, we did it.
Know where it's from. Lewis. We must ask him if we want to get out of this dead end.
All right. Oh, look at that. The case is closed. Game is over. I guess. I don't know.
So, the card is, maybe a dead end. The piece of painting, too.
But the list Filmar gave us...
Exactly. Full of those imposing names. And I only know
now.
One person who moves in similar circles.
Maybe. I think Lamar. I remember.
Yes, Marty. It's Lewis. Exactly.
Of course, it's Lewis. But where do we find the bunny man?
Well, since he owns this building, I'm hoping he's here. It's worth a call.
You know his number?
By heart. 555-932. I wrote it down in my notebook as well.
Oh, you are a professional, Boss Bird.
Well, let's make that phone call. Alright, so he said... Five and two.
Hey, Lewis, sorry to disturb you again. Could you come over to my place? I have a question for you. It's very important. It's about a case.
A real case? With the Chicken police? Of course, sonny. I'll be over in a few minutes.
Thanks, pal. I owe you one.
One? Just a second.
All right. Yeah, oh, wow. He wasn't kidding about the diamond.
Thanks, Lewis. Again.
Oh, don't mention it. Besides, it was my big dream to help you with a serious case.
Well, let's hope you can help. What can you tell me about this list, old pal?
Well, these names. I know half of them personally. Maybe even more.
I knew it.
But I have no idea what kind of list this is.
Here we go.
But these are all members of the upper class. Politicians, business people. Oh my. Even the commander of the Royal Guard.
Damn.
But I really don't know what it means.
So, is it a dead end?
I'm afraid so.
Deborah, the girl who came to me tonight.
Yes, she's a very lovely young lady.
Where did you take her after you two left?
I forgot
he
took her.
She asked me to Flowerville.
I'm pretty good at being a detective, in case you can't tell.
Rochester Street 37?
Yes, exactly. Why?
Cluck.
Did something happen?
Nothing good, Lewis. Nothing good.
This? Oh, my goodness.
I think we have a bingo, gentlemen.
You see, I also have one of these.
A card? Like this? Really?
Yes. It's a membership card to a very exclusive club.
How exclusive?
Very.
That's what I'm talking about.
What does SN mean, Lewis?
It's the sweltering Nile.
But that's a...
Well, yes, it's a brothel. But it's not like that. It's something completely different.
Calm down, Lewis. We're not going to tell anybody.
Thank you so much. It is rather embarrassing.
Listen, Lewis. How do we get in?
You want to get in? Well, if you... Show them this card. They'll surely let you in, but it will be obvious you're not regulars there.
We're used to that.
So, are we going to a luxury brothel?
Correct, Marty. Thanks for the help, Lewis. I owe you one. For the third time today, I think.
Well, let's ask him about the rest of the things.
Said to him, but after you finished, he almost immediately disappeared.
Really? That's suspicious.
Or he had business elsewhere. It's New Year's Eve. Everybody's going somewhere.
I didn't see her after the show. If I'm not mistaken, she usually leaves when everyone else has already left.
What else do you know about her, Lewis?
Oh, not much. What everybody knows. She was a dancer, then a backing singer, then star, and then club owner.
We found out as much already. Do you think she'd fled the Stavonian massacre? That's why the secrecy.
Do you mean the massacre of the royal family? I'd say her accent is a dead giveaway, and her name too, though it's undoubtedly an alias.
So it's possible that she is a part of the royal family?
I don't think so. Nobody could have survived that awful night.
You're probably right. What should we know about the place, Lewis? Besides what they're dealing in there?
No, it's an elegant and exclusive place. Not everybody visits them for that, you know. Some animals just go for company.
I see. I guess it's mostly visited by the upper class.
Mostly, yes. The wealthy who have a taste.
Yes, of course. Is it true what they say, that it's some kind of hidden stronghold of the royalists?
The Nile is a proud herald of the coexistence of all the species, yes, but stronghold? I don't think so.
But the place must be an eyesore for the separatists, right?
Oh, don't worry for the girls, Sunny. They can defend themselves quite well. The separatists wouldn't dare to go near the place.
Well, we'll see what they have to say about these two old cocks.
That was a little bit, equivocal.
Yeah, I don't know that I liked that sentence.
Look, I'm sorry I dragged you into this, Marty.
Ah, don't be. I would have been bored to death, still be on that shooting range.
And Laura, what about her?
She's used to it.
I'm apparently super thirsty, sorry.
You know, since that special one.
Don't say it.
A bloody New Year's. Yeah. So Laura's probably at home, waiting for me on the couch, staring into a candle and killing a bottle of wine. Or two.
You can get out of this any time. You know that, don't you?
If you start something, finish it, right? Let's just make it through alive, okay? Or Laura will bite off my head. Literally.
I'm on it, partner.
All right. I mean, is it worth looking at this stuff with him?
The old days. You know, I miss him sometimes.
What? The hype? Us as celebrity cops?
Nah, the work, the buzz, the phone ringing at 4 a.m. and knowing if you pick it up, you'll be dragged into something terrible, because that's your job. And of course, you pick it up every clucking time.
I'm not sure it's healthy to enjoy that.
Hey, no healthy animal becomes a cop in Clawville.
Yeah, true.
All right, well, that was one I wanted to look at.
It would be best to board it up. It'd go well with this rundown neighborhood.
It may be rundown, but somehow I still feel like it's honest.
Sure. You could live in Cockroach Town. That's an honest place, too. Has a similar stink.
Believe me, Marty, I thought about it.
Why am I not surprised?
All right. Clues. The card we found on Deborah is a membership card of a luxury brothel, the Sweltering Nile. This is going places. All right. So, Lewis, well, seems like old Thumper likes to kill time in a very luxurious way. Don't like that sentence. Sweltering Nile is an almost legendary luxury brothel that is visited mainly by members of the upper crust and by Lewis, as it turned out recently. All right. Well, I guess it's time to go to the Sweltering Nile. Oh, hey. There are chapters.
The
I don't know if I knew
light.
That.
We were heading toward the most exclusive brothel in Clawville. The Separatists and those opposing the monarchy hated the place, just like they hated everything that supported interracial relations and peaceful coexistence of all species. So the place wasn't just a brothel. It was a symbol. But just like a brothel is not a worthy symbol, Clawville failed to turn out the way it was intended.
Well, here we are. The kingdom of long legs, silky skin, and fluttering lashes. We've arrived.
Calm down, Marty. Watch your blood pressure.
Oh, wow. The lemur lady makes me uncomfortable, as does Sam the Eagle back there. Is that a hot dog picture? What is... Okay, we're going to cut this off here in a second because I think we're about to start something that's going to move forward a good bit. And, you know, you got different sultry pictures up here, but that one just looks like a hot dog. Oh, all right, well.
I don't even know. Good gods.
Hey, keep it down, Marty.
I see it now. Of all that's furry.
Yes, it's very furry. Or more like, shaggy.
Okay, don't like that. Foxy. Bird fella. Yeah, I'm gonna stop this here. Yeah. It's making me a little uncomfortable, I'm not gonna lie. I don't know how I feel about these animals. Well, we'll throw this back to you. If you like what you see, give us a like. Consider subscribing. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.